Okay. It's Movie Time is produced by John DeSando. Listen to full shows and read reviews online at WCBE.org.
I'm John DeSando.
And I'm Courtney Hughes.
And this is It's Movie Time. And it's holiday time. So let's have a holiday movie called The Nutcracker and the Four Realms.
Wonderful movie. Wonderful family movie, I thought.
What's it about?
I don't really know. It's a young girl's journey into strange places, very much an Alice in Wonderland and a Charlie in the Chocolate Factory.
Right.
Willy Wonka-ish. Yeah. Thankfully, without any Johnny Depp.
Right, with a little bit of Wizard of Oz.
Little Wizard of Oz.
Mixed in there.
Right, right.
All right, so Mackenzie Foy plays Clara.
She didn't really get it for me. I thought she was kind of a simple, you know, I didn't think there was a lot of oomph in
well, when you've got Keira Knightley jumping all over the set.
Grabbing the screen, chewing up the scenery.
Right. She plays Sugar Plum.
She was wonderful.
She's like the nice angel from somewhere.
Yeah, it's not well, quite more the Wicked Witch.
Exactly, yeah. But she's both, and that's what I love about it. She, mm-hmm. she turns the, and that's one of the charms I think of this film, is that not everything is as it seems. And it was the same with Helen Mirren, who plays Ginger Snaps, or what is
Mother
her name?
Mother Ginger.
Mother Ginger, mm-hmm. Right, and she's supposedly
the bad one.
She's the bad lady. Yeah, yeah.
No, it turns out not to be.
Right. And so Clara's job, after her mother, who was really the queen, has died. And this is another part of this, and I think why you kind of hesitated about summarizing it, because, yeah, it's like so many other young films.
And the dead mother, and the daughter doesn't know what to do, and the father's lost. You know, does it always have to be the dead mother?
No, it doesn't.
It shouldn't always have to be, but of course that sets her on her journey.
Yes, and you know, it's interesting because there are a few films out there in which the daughter and father have to connect because the mother is gone. And while I think that the fragmented family theme is being played regularly, that is people trying to get back with their families, this one about the young girl and the dad seems to me to fit into the fairy tale motif better than any.
I just again wish that Disney didn't always have to go to, you know, a parent is dead, so then we have to go on.
Yeah,
can there not just be another reason for her journey?
Yeah, yeah. But I thought that they did it fine if they're going to follow that formula. And there, it is a formulaic film. I mean, she goes into a magic kingdom. She meets up with some eccentric characters. She has to face down the Wicked Witch and then go back home.
Right. Amazingly. And nothing has happened since she's been gone. It is this. Dorothy has come back to Kansas and, you know, wakes up.
Right.
Oh, you know, no time has passed. So I thought extremely formulaic, but I did really appreciate the costumes and the makeup were fantastic and the sets.
The
were
sets
very, very good.
Were incredible. I thought, you know, and we've certainly with CGI, we have grown accustomed to some pretty fantastic stuff. But this stuff looked real.
It did look real. I appreciated the Mother Ginger's, you know, the downtrodden amusement park, I thought was well done.
Yes, yes.
And, of course, the castle, and which was very Russian, didn't you?
It was. It had the domes on. And I loved the tin soldiers.
They were well done. I mean, they were, you know, crazy scary.
Yes.
You know, very. That was the one part where I was just trying to pay attention to how they did it, you know, how they made them come alive.
Well, look, how can a movie go wrong when you have Morgan Freeman playing a godlike character again?
Oh, what a stretch. Stepping outside his comfort zone.
Dressing.
Looking crustier than ever. Just wash your face or clean up a little bit. He seemed dirtier than normal, maybe.
But he has this kind of emporium with all this strange stuff in it. And he's actually her godfather. Clara's godfather, I think, or she calls him godfather.
Right.
Dresselmeyer is his real name, but he calls him godfather. And he kind of sets things going because, of course, they have to find a key to unlock some parts of her world.
Which magically comes around to say, you didn't need a key. It was in you all the time.
I know, Otto. I love that.
You know.
I know, right? She opens up and she says, you have it all.
It's all right inside. Inside here or inside here.
Courtney, now we're mashing a little bit this movie when in fact it is... has a really good heart.
It does. It does. And I thought it was wonderful for all ages. Nothing too scary, you know, just a little bit, but, you know, funny in the scariness. So
yeah.
Nothing, I thought, no blood, no guts, you know, and a wonderful young man playing the Nutcracker who I thought was delightful. I was distracted a bit by his makeup. You know, they had like a shine on the top of his lip, which just was a bit distracting for me, and I wasn't sure why they did that. Did you notice what, you know what I was
saying? Well, and for his career, I don't know why his teeth are so white.
His teeth were so white, yes.
Jeez, it's like
very
Denzel.
Bright.
Denzel does the same thing.
Yes.
His teeth are just, were way too white.
Way too white. but a charming young man, I
thought. Oh, very nice. Unassuming, look cute as heck in his Nutcracker outfit.
Mm-hmm.
And I really liked Mackenzie Foy as Clara. I think she has, I agree with you, she's a bit understated.
A bit dull.
Right,
bit dull.
She's a bit dull, but she looks great. She couldn't be more than 16.
No, she does look fantastic. And her fight scenes, I thought she was effective, you know, when she has to come around and fight the tin soldiers. But I just felt a little lacking, there was not enough spark there in her for me.
Right.
Just a bit muted around the edges.
Yeah. And I think that the directors probably wanted her. I mean, Lasse Hallström, who directed Cider House Rules, is one, and Joe Johnston, are the two directors. And I think they probably made her underplay it so that the other characters could come out, like Mirren and Knightley.
Mirren Knightley, right.
Yeah, and so they could emphasize them, or perhaps also to stress her goody-goodiness.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
She was just a bit weak for me.
But this is a film where, when you go there, you are transported like her.
I agree.
And there's nobody that can transport better than Disney. And these are beautiful sets.
Mm-hmm.
Extravagant
and
costumes.
Fantastic costumes.
Oh,
and the supporting characters I thought were well done. You know, the different leaders of each realm, the flower and the candy, when they went into the candy world.
Oh, yes.
They just went crazy in the audience. Yeah.
Well, Courtney Hughes, the film is The Nutcracker and the Four Realms. What grade would you give it?
I'm going to give it a strong B.
Oh, good for you. And I'm going to give it a strong B plus because I'm really very generous-hearted at the holiday times.
Well, that's good. Thank you for being here.